So while Chelsea is teaching Emma the fine art of putting away bearded dragon eggs, I'm going to do a video on the difference between fertile and infertile eggs. This is going to be a good example.
So on the fertile ones, you can see the light pink circles on each one. And they look, that's where the embryo implanted on the egg.
So like that one I lifted straight up, the embryo was on top. But every once in a while the dragon will kind of knock them to the side when she buries them.
Yeah.
Usually it's not a big deal in the first 24 hours.
Got it.
She laid a whole bunch.
Excuse me?
And the fertile ones are like usually larger than the infertile. They're a lot plumper, more firm and solid.
She just...
Oh my gosh. Oh,
we need to pull those apart.
Oh dear. Oh my goodness.
She.
She's also candling them, and when you candle them, you can see exactly where they were each implanted. You can see it really good, but it doesn't show up well on this camera.
Yeah, that's probably just because my phone's on real bright, so I can see them. Good.
Yeah.
That one's a little, maybe just a little dehydrated. That's alright. It's just a little bit, like, wrinkly. That's all. It's not very bad at all.
Yeah, sometimes fertile eggs, if it's the soil's not moist enough, they are a little
but that's not, you
wrinkly.
Can't even, you can't even see it. You can only tell by touch, so that's
yeah.
That's not even.
Yeah. Not some you can see it, but others, no. But once you get them in the moist vermiculite, then they usually plump up. In a few hours, we've had to do that for some people drop them off and they've dried out a little bit, and then we have to put them in there and get them plumped back up. And these are the clutches from the video, from Tuesday's video, so yeah. This was the experienced breeder's clutch, who had a bunch, had like two dud clutches this year so far, but then one of our males, we saw him successfully mate with her, and it looks like he did his job. All right, so the second clutch is from our first time egg layer.
Are they in that corner?
Our red, they're right
corner.
Here. Our red hypo-translucent leatherback female. The first clutches are usually always bad. Very rarely have we gotten one that,
Look weird.
Yeah.
Let's see what happens.
Yeah.
Ooh, they're tiny.
They're some, tiny?
Actually, that one's not bad.
Ooh, there might be a few gems
so,
in there.
Should we get rid of these little ones? I don't even think they're...
Oh,
they're,
yeah.
They're, they're going to go bad right away.
Yeah. Okay, so she's going to show you.
This one doesn't even have
these...
embryo.
So, see,
they're
yeah.
tiny and squishy and not even really egg-shaped, and I'm sure they're just
this
probably...
This one's good?
Yeah.
They're like yellow all the way through the layer, like jelly beans. Happy Easter.
So it looks like we got a mix of good ones and bad ones in there.
Okay, so there is an
yep.
embryo in that one, so she may have had some duds, but...
yeah. Okay, so one. It looks like she had a mix of infertile and fertile, which is pretty good for the first
I don't know how
time.
Eggs ran in, so we'll just put it in one cup. Because if we don't fill a cup, we don't fill a cup.
But yeah, these are obviously spuds. I call them spuds. They're squishy and tiny.
Formed.
Yeah. But you
however,
can tell the difference. Yeah, and then she's...
Yeah.
She's got some good
yeah.
ones.
Yeah, but they're candling them, and they have the embryo ring in there.
Mm-hmm.
So it looks like M2 did his job. Good boy, little M2, because that's the only male she's been with. Oh, look at the spuds.
Oh, okay, hold on.
Squishy.
So that one's not...
Oh, oh, oh. We have one that kind of looks good and kind of... I'm not seeing anything there. Sometimes they can be plump too, but we'll save the plump
safe.
Ones just to say see. Alrighty, so after seeing those, you should have a pretty good idea of the difference between fertile and infertile eggs. These are bad, and those are all good.
And one medium one.
And one kind of in the middle. Not quite
I don't have much hope for that one, but we'll see what happens. I hate to...
Yeah, might as well give it a chance. If it goes bad, we can just throw it away.